हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू योर इंग्लिश क्लास। आई होप यू ऑल आर फिट एंड फाइन एंड एंजॉयिंग योर ऑनलाइन लर्निंग। सो टुडे वील स्टडी द चैप्टर द साउंड ऑफ म्यूजिक। दिस चैप्टर इज डिवाइडेड इनटू टू पार्ट्स। पार्ट फर्स्ट इज एवेलिन ग्लेनी लिसन्स टू साउंड विदाउट हियरिंग इट। लेट्स डिस्कस द टाइटल फर्स्ट। इट इज़ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग दैट एवेलिन ग्लेनी लिसन्स टू साउंड विदाउट हियरिंग इट। Now, we are wondered and confused also that how can someone who is not able to hear listen music? So, this is the thing we will discover in this chapter. So, before we proceed to the chapter, let's read first. God may have taken her hearing, but He has given her back something extraordinary. What we hear, she feels far more deeply than any of us. That is why she expresses music so beautifully. Someone has commented about Evelyn that though God took away her hearing part, she was impaired, but He gave her an extraordinary thing, that is feeling. So she could feel very deeply, far more deeply than the normal people. This is the reason because of which she is able to express music very well. She is a well-known multi-percussionist. She plays different percussion instruments like xylophone, drums, tabla, etc. Then, read the following account of a person who fought against a physical disability and made her life a success story. From here, we come to know the theme of the story or the message that we get from the story. The story of Evelyn Glennie is a motivational story. It inspires all of us to overcome our physical disabilities and proceed on the path of success just like Evelyn did. So let's proceed with the chapter. Rush hours crowd jostle for position on the underground train platform. Jostle means push roughly. The scene is the train platform, that is underground, and there is a huge rush of people. A slight girl, looking younger than her 17 years, was nervous yet excited as she felt the vibrations of approaching train. There is a small thin girl who is Evelyn. She is walking at the railway platform and waiting for her train. She felt excited and nervous when she realized by the vibrations that the train was about to come. This is the train that will take Evelyn to London. She is going to London to learn music, as she got admission in the Royal Academy of Music in London. So, it was her first day at prestigious Royal Academy of Music in London, and daunting enough for any teenager fresh from a Scottish farm. Daunting means frightening, or you can say scary. So, because she is going towards London, she belongs to Scotland and it is not so fast like London. London has a very fast life, whereas Scotland has farms and countryside. So that's why Evelyn is nervous, because she is leaving Scotland for London and going to a new place. She is excited so because it is her first day in the academy and now her dream is going to be fulfilled. So, she is too excited to reach there. But this aspiring musician faced a bigger challenge than most. She was profoundly deaf. And so, she is too excited to reach there. She was absolutely deaf and not able to hear anything. So, it was a bigger challenge for her. For a normal people to travel from Scotland to London is not so tough like Evelyn. Why was it tough for Evelyn? Because she was deaf and she was going to a new country. So it was a bigger challenge for her. Because how could she able to adjust in a fully new environment with her hearing impairedness? But she was fully determined to achieve her goal. Evelyn Glennie's loss of hearing had been gradual. Evelyn's loss of hearing occurred in phases. Her mother remembers noticing something was wrong when the 8-year-old Evelyn was waiting to play the piano. They called her name and she didn't move. I suddenly realized that she hadn't heard, says Isabel Glennie. The name of her mother is Isabel Glennie, and she recollects a memory when she was 8 years old and she was waiting for her turn to play the piano, but when her name was called out, she didn't react or respond. Then her mother realized that something is wrong with her hearing ability. So, for quite a while, Evelyn managed to conceal her growing deafness from friends and teachers. As Evelyn's hearing loss was occurred gradually, so in the beginning time of her hearing loss, when she could partially listen, she tried to hide her disability from her friends and teachers. But by the time she was 11, her marks had deteriorated and her headmistress asked her parents to take her to a specialist. Deteriorated means reduced. But when she was 11 years old, her performance in study becoming poor and her marks were also reduced. At that time, her principal also noticed her problem and called her parents to request them to take Evelyn to a specialist or a doctor, you can say. It was then discovered that her hearing was severely impaired as a result of gradual nervous damage. Now, when the specialist checked up, he found that it was a serious hearing loss because her nerve was totally damaged. They were advised that she should be fitted with hearing aids and sent to a school for the deaf. After checking, they also suggested her to take help of some hearing aids and take admission in special school made for the disabled children. After knowing this, Evelyn became disappointed. Everything suddenly looked black, says Evelyn. She was feeling distressed and she was feeling like darkness all around. She was feeling disappointed now. But Evelyn was not going to give up. She was determined to lead a normal life and pursue her interest in music. But Evelyn was not the girl who gave up easily. She was fully determined girl and she decided to live a normal and happy life and develop her interest in music. So, one day she noticed a girl playing a xylophone and decided that she wanted to play it too. Xylophone, you can see in this picture, it is a musical instrument. One day she saw a girl who was playing xylophone. After watching her performance, she also very impressed with her and decided that she would learn to play xylophone. So, most of the teachers discouraged her, but percussionist Ron Forbes spotted her potential. So, when she went to her previous school, many teachers suggested her to remain at home, as it is not possible to learn music without hearing. But Ron Forbes, who was a percussionist means a person who plays some musical instruments like tabla, drum, you can say. He noticed that she has potential to learn music and she was passionate about music. So, he decided to do something for her. He began by tuning two large drums of two different notes. So, first of all, what he did? He decided to train Evelyn. So he took two large drums and he tuned each drum to different note so that the sound on each drum create different vibration. And he said, "Don't listen through your ears." He would say, "Try to sense it some other way." He also inspired Evelyn, "Don't try to listen music through your ears. Just feel the vibrations to learn music." Now, as Ron Forbes set the drums in the different tunes, I realized I could feel the higher drum from the waist up and lower one from the waist down. Waist, the middle part of your body. So, Evelyn says that the drum which made higher note, she could feel through the upper part of her body. And she could feel the lower note through the lower part of her body. Means down to her waist. Then, Forbes repeated the exercise and soon Evelyn discovered that she could sense certain notes in different parts of her body. trained her so much that she could able to feel music through different parts of her body. When she would be able to identify the notes through the vibrations, the obstacle could be overcome and she could achieve her goal. So, Evelyn says that I had learned to open my mind and body to sounds and vibrations. She says that she was fully attentive to learn music. The rest was sheer determination and hard work. Her career went upward because she was fully dedicated and determined to achieve her goal. She never looked back from the points onwards. She toured the United Kingdom with a youth orchestra, and by the time she was 16, she had decided to make music her life. Once Evelyn overcome her challenge, she started to feel the different notes of music through the different parts of her body. She progressed in her career. Evelyn traveled United Kingdom and performed youth orchestra. Youth orchestra means a group of young musicians. When she was 16 years old, she decided to give her whole life to music only. She auditioned for the Royal Academy of Music and scored one of the highest marks in the history of the Academy. She gave auditions for the Royal Academy of Music and scored good marks. No other person had scored such good marks like Evelyn. Though, she gradually moved from orchestral work to solo performances. Though, she used to give performance in a group, but now she decided to do some extra. So, she decided to do solo performances also. At the end of her 3-year course, she had captured most of the top awards. It was a result of her tough-mindedness and hard work that during her 3-year course in music, she won so many top awards in music. And for all this, Evelyn won't accept any hint of heroic achievement. If anyone says that Evelyn has done something great, she doesn't acknowledge that because she is very humble and down to earth. She says that if you work hard and know where you are going, you will get there. Where you are going means what is your goal. So, she says that the two important things are necessary for gaining success in life. First is hard work, and second is your aim, or you can say target or goal. She worked hard and focused towards her goal, so she is a top musician now. And she got right to the top, the world's most sought after multi-percussionist with a mastery of some 1,000 instruments and hectic international schedule. Sought after means popular. Hectic means busy. Now, she is the world's most popular top percussionist. And she also gained mastery over some 1,000 instruments. So, just because of her hard work and determination, she has achieved her goal to be a top musician. Now, she has a very busy schedule as she has to give performance on the international level also. So, in this way, she achieved success only because of her focused goal and hard work and firm determination. So, students, you can also get inspiration from the character of Evelyn Glennie. The next part will continue in the next class. I hope this is clear to all. Thank you, children.